is in this place and the Lord is in your house.
Yes, Lord.
He's in this place and he's in your house, for the Holy Ghost is everywhere that we invite him to. So now we're going to hear from the Holy Spirit. That same Holy Spirit that we sang to and raised hand to and danced to, that same God that's with us now wants to speak, for he is a communicator. He likes to communicate to us, for he loves us so much. Do you not love someone and never talk to them? Do you love someone and barely talk to them? God likes to speak. He's going to speak to your life. God is so good. Let's hear from the Lord.
Yes.
Let's hear from the Lord. Pastor, my wife, I am bringing the first message of 2022.
Special soda. They knew that their house was a house of fire, and anybody could come to
Thank you. transformational power. It was a transformational experience. It grabs my heart when I read those verses, and it says that they were devoted. The fire comes upon them, and all suddenly they are devoted. The Merriam-Webster dictionary says that devoted is a feeling of strong love and loyalty. But I want to take you somewhere today. It is the quality of using your time, of using your money, of using your energy, anything for a particular cause. In the Christian world, it is prayer, it is worship, or other religious activity that is done in practice and in private. You want to tell me you're devoted? Tell me, how is your life at home? Tell me, how is your life when you leave this building? Tell me what crosses your mind when you get in your car. Tell me what you're looking at on your computer screen. Tell me what you're observing. Tell me what shows you're watching. Tell me what life you're living. Devotion. But then it also says that loyalty is very different from devotion. For devotion goes above loyalty. You see, loyalty is believing in something or someone. Devoted is going to a higher level. Loyalty means you stand by a person or a cause, and you support them, and you are not easily persuaded to abandon them. I'm loyal, you say. I'm loyal. But devotion goes a little bit farther. Devotion says, I love them. I am devoted and I'm loyal, but I love them. That is the difference. You have many loyal people, but do these people really love? Do you really love? One of the signs of true revival is transformation. Transformation. And I'm going to read these words that come from Pastor John Kilpatrick. And I need for you to listen. As the body of Christ here on earth today, we want to live out these days of heaven on earth, where the demonstration of God's power becomes the norm and not the exception. Do you agree? Do you agree that you want to show up to a church where the power of God is manifested? And it's not only in special occasions, but it's always, because God is always powerful. So there should be the Lord around us and in our gatherings.
Right.
Continues to say, we are not content with getting a touch from God. Then going home, listen to me. Then going home only to live the same way that we lived before with that touch. Hey! Those days are over!
Come on, yes!
Those days are over!
Yes.
We are hungry in this hour to see the move of God sustained from generation to generation. You want to start living a transformative life that not only you carry the glory of God, but you transfer it to your children and to your grandchildren and to the next generation that is to come. For we do not know when the heavens will open and when will God descend, but we do know that we are called to be on fire for God from generation to generation.
Break the chain. Break the chain. Come on.
Let me take you deeper. It was Welsh minister Martin Lloyd-Jones, who was born in 1899, and he described the battle this way. And I was in awe because a man that said the same exact words as we were worshiping. The tragedy is that many of us are living a desperate Christian life. Something comes and we get some strength. See, many people are not here today because they're sick. But there are many of you that are not sick, that you could have been here. Yet you decided to stay home. But tomorrow at 6, you're going to be up going to a job that you don't know who's infected and who's not infected. But there you are with your mask, doing your job.
Speak.
terrible suffering. And on the last day, the greatest day of the festival, Jesus stood up and said in a loud voice, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me and drink." Next verse 8. "Whoever believes in me, as scripture has said, rivers of living water will flow from within you."
That's right. That's right.
Do you believe?
Yeah.
my land. And there were times when I found myself alone. And my husband would walk in and take a peek and tap me and say, baby, don't worry, I'll join you. And I said, don't worry, I got God by my side. I know who I'm talking to. Because the men are usually so tired working hard. And he said, 6 a.m. A couple of days a week, no, every day. I said, what? I was one of them upset. I was one of them upset. Okay? You know, we women were praying for our men to be on fire. And then when they want to be on fire, we're the first ones putting stupid excuses. And they'll turn on the light at 6 a.m. because you're going to wake me up. Who cares if he wakes you up? Praise God.
Come on. Come on.
Abuse coming out of the mouth of the man who was here in the altar. starts always with prayer. Prayer is going to lead us to a life of repentance. And in order to repent, we have to look ourselves in the mirror of the Word of God and know and see what needs to be transformed. From that repentance, we receive forgiveness and restoration and transformation. And God, does He love you? Of course He loves you. He loves you when you're sinning, and He loves you when you're not sinning. For He prefers to see you in victory. How can we do it, you say? How can I take what I feel here? What I feel in this altar? What I feel when I am worshiping God? How can we do it? I can only tell you that it is only done by responding to the touch of the Holy Spirit that you receive in this altar. It requires for us to readjust our lives. Readjust. It requires that we're going to have to start collaborating with the Holy Spirit through obedience to God and yielding to His word. You cannot obey what God has called you to do because 2, 3, 4, 5 months ago, a year ago, He gave you an order and you never listened to it. Then you're complaining that you don't hear the voice of God. Why will He continue speaking to you? Did you do the last thing that He told you to do? Did we do it? We readjust our lives by collaborating with the Holy Spirit. By yielding, we need to understand that the revival we are expecting here is designed to make adjustments and discipline easier. Because every time you are touched by God, it is God empowering you, listen to me, empowering you so that when you leave these four walls, you are an overcomer. influence that culture. I don't see nobody here wearing a bell bottoms from the 50s. Right? Some of you have already transitioned out of the skinny jeans. Now it's a low boho style. Yes, because we are influenced. Atmosphere is defined of as the air of a place. Listen. Atmosphere will define your surroundings, what you feel, and how you react to what you feel. The atmosphere of a tropical place is warm and sunny. In other places like Aspen, the atmosphere is cold and snowy. Now, some of the warm places may experience some abnormalities in temperature. We've heard of orange crops being lost in Florida because of suddenly a cold front came. People wearing coats in the wee hours in the inland parts of a tropical island like Puerto Rico in a town called Maricao. Because temperatures drop. Nevertheless, the predominant atmosphere in these places are warm and sunny. That's their atmosphere. Even though in our place, create a climate that is conducive to the fruit of the Spirit. You will walk in character and in power. You will walk in character and in power. People that are people of revival have character and have power.
From the night before service visited, and they would get to their house, and
magician that is of you. We see you one day and we don't see you between months. What is going on? What is he asking? Is he telling you how to manage your time? Oh, because you're always saying you don't have time. Sometimes I feel that you're running the Tesla company, that you're like Elon Musk's right hand because you're always so busy. How do you manage your time? What programs and what apps do you have on your phone? What time are they taking? What relationships God wants you to cut once and for all?
Two minutes.
care for them. Do you understand what I'm telling you? Do you understand what I'm telling you? You cannot tell the Lord, bring me the brokenhearted, bring me the divorced, bring me the gang leaders, bring me the prostitutes, bring me the crazy lady from the neighborhood, bring me my crazy uncle, bring me my homosexual, sexually confused friend and relative. If you don't have what you're going to need to care for them.
Change.
church had a culture of continuous power because they managed to sustain an atmosphere of presence. How many of you say you're going to lose weight this year?
Yourself be built. You either let yourself be your own. You want to go to a church.